Professional friends, today we are going to see three different interest subjects. First is penalty on receipt of an amount of rupees 2 lakh or more in cash under Income Tax Act 1961. Section 269 ST, as inserted by the Finance Act of 2017 with effect from 1st April 2017, provides that no person shall receive an amount of rupees 2 lakhs or more in cash and aggregate from a person in a day as amended by the Finance Act 2020 in respect of a single transaction and in respect of transaction relating to one event or occasion from a person otherwise than by an account pay check or account pay bank draft or use of electronic clearing system through a bank account or through such other electronic mode as may be prescribed. However, the said restriction shall not apply to government, any banking company, post office, savings bank, cooperative bank, or any person notified by the central government. Penalty for contravention. Section 271 DA provides for levy of penalty on a person who receives a sum in contravention of the provisions of the section 269 ST. The penalty shall be equal to the amount of such receipt. However, the penalty shall not be levied if the person proves that there were good and sufficient reasons for such contravention. Example: X organizes a marriage reception in a star hotel and the hotel charges him a bill of rupees 5 lakh. X clears the bill in 5 installments of rupees 1 lakh each on 4 different dates. Here the cash receipts got by hotel are less than rupees 2 lakhs received on different dates, but it is related to a single bill or single transaction. Here hotel will be liable for the penalty of rupees 5 lakhs for splitting up the payments over several days will also attract penalty. So friends, you have to be very careful in spending your money. If you spend more than 2 lakhs, then the receiver will be in soup. They have to pay the penalty of equal on merchandise. MEIS merchandise export from India scheme incentive is withdrawn against the exports made from 1st January 2021. So, MEIS scheme is not available from 1st January 2021 to exporters in India. MEIS scheme, DGFT, Merchandise Export from India scheme. What is MEIS scheme? More than 4,000 items of exports are eligible to get benefits under MEIS DGFT. Under MEIS scripts shall be granted as rewards for the exporters. The value of the scripts is 2% to 5% of the FOB value of the goods exported. The scripts will be freely transferable against goods imported or domestically procured. First time exporters from SEEC are also covered under this initiative. Objective of MEIS scheme DGFT. Merchandise exports from the India scheme MEIS aims to offset the infrastructural inefficiency and associated cost involved in the export of goods or products produced as well as the manufacture in our country, especially product of high export intensity, employment potential, and to improve India's export competitiveness in the world, improve India's export competitiveness in the world's market. Under Merchandise Export from India scheme, Government of India provides up to 5% incentive to exporters. Following are the main features of the MEIS script. They are issued to exporters. The script allows duty deduction, one payment of taxes of a specified amount in the script. The script value of the amount of tax deduction will be specified in the script. The script value of the our tax deduction is expressed as a percentage of export turnover of the exporter. The script value usually varies between 3% to 5% of under Foreign Trade Policy 2015. What is duty credit script? Duty credit scrip or scrips given to exporters as incentives by the Government of India through Merchandise Exports from India Scheme, MEI Scheme. Scrips are given to for goods exports and through service exports also from India. Service exports also are eligible for incentives. Yeah, that is called SEIS Scheme, are given for service exports also. So, recent amendment. What is the recent amendment in this regard? MEI scheme, incentive scheme is withdrawn. It is no more available against exports made from 1st January 2021. MEIS incentives against exports made between 1st September 2020 and 31st December 2020 is limited to rupees 2 crores per importer-exporter quote and subject to following conditions. Additional conditions, then no MEIS incentive for exporters registered under IEC after 1st September 2020. If you are going to register and get the IEC code after 1st September 2020, you will not be eligible for this scheme. No MEIS incentive for exporters who have not made exports during 1 year preceding to 1st September 2020. The MEIS incentive may be subject to downward revision of the incentives claimed crosses to allocated budget of 5,000 crores. If government spends more than 5,000 crores, then it can revise on downwards. Benefit of the MEIS for exporters. The MEIS incentive may be subject to downward revision of the incentives claimed if it crosses allocated budget of rupees 5,000 crores. Benefit of MEIS for exports for the period from 1st September 2020 to 31st December 2020 is restricted to rupees 2 crores per IEC. Benefit of MEIS is not eligible to IEC holder who did not do any export during the period from 1st September 2019 to 31st August 2020, as well as a new IEC holder who registered after 1st September 2020. Benefit of MEIS is not eligible with the effect from 1st January 2021. So it is being withdrawn. This scheme is totally is going to be withdrawn from the 1st January 2021. The third category is stamp paper do not have any expiry period, held a Supreme Court in Thiruvengadam Pillai versus Ramaneetha Ammal and another. In this case, it's a very interesting case. According to the Supreme Court judgment dated 19th February 2008, in the case of Thiruvengadam Pillai versus Ramaneetha Ammal and another, the stamp papers do not have any expiry period. Relevant extract from the Supreme Court judgment is reproduced herein below. The Indian Stamp Act, 1899, nowhere prescribe any expiry date for use of a stamp paper. Section 54 merely provides that person possessing a stamp paper for which he has no immediate use, which is not spoiled or rendered unfit or useless, can seek refund of the value thereof by surrendering such stamp paper to the collector, provided it was purchased within the period of 6 months next preceding the date on which it was surrendered. The stipulation of the period of 6 months prescribed under Section 54 of the Stamp Act, Indian Stamp Act, is only for the purpose of seeking refund of the value of the unused stamp paper and not for the use of stamp paper. Section 54 does not require the person who has purchased the stamp paper to use it within 6 months. Therefore, there is no impediment for a stamp paper purchased more than 6 months prior to the proposed date of execution being used for a documentation judicial stamp paper, if not unfit or useless to execute, can be used any time. So this stamp paper can be used any time, there is no time limit. However, if you are seeking a refund of unused stamps, you need to approach the collector within 6 months as per Section 54 of the Indian Stamp Act 1899. So stamp paper, if you are having a stamp paper purchased 2 years back, then you can use it, or 6 months back you can use it, or 1 year back you can use it now. So there is no any deadline for stamp paper. So this is the crux of the Supreme Court judgment in that above case. Friends, I think you will be very, very much benefited of the information what I have provided in this video. If you like this video, I request you to subscribe my channel so that whenever issue new topics, it will come to you directly. Thanking you once again, R.V. Shekhar, practicing company secretary.